Hey, what's going on, everybody? My name is Monatubi, coach of the Tampa Bay Lux Raves, and today I'm bringing you guys our GBA Season 7 Week 11 match versus Old Man Tup, coach of the Pittsburgh Piratitas. If you have not done so already, please check out his YouTube link in the description below. He is a great guy, great friend of mine, and like I mentioned in the last time that we played, he is one of the biggest reasons as to why I am in the GBA. So thank you very much to him, although we do have to end up beating him in this game, because if we are able to win this game, we are actually clinched for playoffs. It's very likely that we make it. Either we have to win one of our next two games, or Lars has to lose one of his next two games. So, it would be a lot easier for us if we were just able to clinch it in this game. Regardless, there are a couple things I need to apologize for before we get into this game. There are a couple of videos missing on my channel. Those are a couple of PPL videos, as well as the team builder for this game. I'm a little bit pressed for time at the moment, but school will be wrapping up this weekend, so hopefully after this I'll have some time to record what I want to record, so I'll be able to record more team builders, more PPL games, as well as the March Madness games, which I would like to record that happened a few months ago, or a month or so ago. But regardless, let's just get into the team. As you can see, he decided to bring his Hydreigon, Tapu Koko, Staraptor, Steelix, Chandelure, and Cryogonal. It's a very similar team he brought last time, except he had something else. I believe he had Scizor instead of the Steelix. And as for my team, I changed it up a little bit. We have Scarf Rose Raid, same set as last time. After that, we have Physically Defensive Florges, Moonblast, Hidden Power Ground, Wish Protect. Then we have Jirachi, that is going to be a speedy, offensive, but leftovers Jirachi, 3 attacks toxic. We have our Choice Specs Greninja. Same set as last time, still puts in a lot of work versus his team. Then we have fully specially defensive Rhydon. This is a new set and a new Pokemon that we did not bring last time. With the full special defense investment, we are able to take anything from the Tapu Koko, including a Life Orb Grass Knot. The only thing he can knock me out with is like a Specs Grass Knot, which is very nice. It's also able to kind of take on the Hydreigon, kind of able to take on the Chandelure, can take on the Staraptor very well. Even though I'm fully Spidef, I can still take a Bandit Close Combat and knock it out with Rock Blast, which is nice. Then we have a sub 3 attacks Akaberry Buzzwole. Because he has things like Blissey on his team, I'll be able to sub up versus them as they go for Seismic Toss, which is very nice. Obviously, he decided not to bring it, which makes sense. But yeah, that is going to be the team, so let us just hop into the game. As you're going to see here, he leads off with his Tapu Koko as I lead with my Rhydon. Like I said, I can beat this thing 1v1, assuming he's not Specs, which I don't think he would be. So I'm just going to go right for the Earthquake as he sends in his Steelix, actually. Maybe expecting me to go for Rocks, but regardless, I'm able to smack that thing with an Earthquake. And then on the following turn, I will be able to get up my Rocks as he gets his Rocks as well. And then, because I don't want this thing to take too much damage so that I can switch into the Staraptor, I'm going to go right out into my Buzzwole as he reveals the Roar, phasing me right back out in my Rhydon. Because I think he's going to click Roar once again, I'm just going to go for the Earthquake. I do end up critting him, which, as you're going to see here, is not really going to make that much of a difference because he's going to Roar me out into Rose Raid. And whether I crit him or not, this Giga Drain would have been able to knock him out anyway. But regardless, his Steelix is down, and that is very nice for my team. That's very nice for my Florges, which is going to be very useful, very good for my Jirachi. He's going to send out his Cryogonal then, and he's going to be able to get off a Rapid Spin here, which is not the worst thing in the world for me. Even though the Rocks would be nice for things like the Staraptor and Chandelure, I am going to be able to keep up momentum as I will be able to go for the U-turn as the Chandelure wants to come in. And then I will be able to go right out into my Florges. I didn't want to go into Rhydon just in case he had Energy Ball, because that would have knocked me out from the range that I'm at. So we're going to go out into our Florges. He's going to hit me with a Fire Blast as I throw up a Wish. And because he is now locked, or what I assume to be locked into Fire Blast, I can just fire off a Moon Blast because it'll get damage off onto whatever he wants to send in. And if he decides to stay in with his Chandelure, that'll be taking chip damage, and he will not be able to knock me out with the Fire Blast. So he allows me to get some damage off onto his Cryogonal, which is very nice. I'm then going to send in Jirachi as he goes for the Flash Cannon. And now what I can do is, because I know he's going to send in his Chandelure, instead of going for U-turn once again and repeating the process, I'm actually just going to go for Heart Stamp so that I can get some chip damage off onto this Chandelure. Because Heart Stamp is relatively free versus his team. He obviously could go out into Hydreigon, but I can U-turn out versus that thing and get some damage off onto it. And I always have a safe switch and a Florges on that thing. So that was the play that I decided to go for. Here he's going to go for Shadow Ball on my Florges. I'm going to take it, then I'm going to go for Wish. And I kind of expected him to go for Brave Bird, not wanting to predict anything. But he is going to predict me to go right out in a Rhydon. Even if he had gone for close combat there, I would have been able to take it. But I will be able to take the U-turn, and then I will be able to get my Rhydon back to full health as he actually sends out his Chandelure, which I'm very okay with because of my fully Spadef investment, I'll actually be able to take that energy ball and then knock him out with the Earthquake, which is very nice for me, because now one of the biggest problems to my team is gone. It was able to outspeed and knock out my Jirachi, my Greninja if it was scarfed, so that's really good for me. With my Rodon being so low, I have to sack it off to the Staraptor, which is okay, because I do have my Jirachi to still kind of deal with that Staraptor, resisting both stabs and taking close combat neutrally. He's then going to go out into his Cryogonal. He's just going to get chip damage off onto my Jirachi, because he doesn't want to switch anything in. And I'll be able to get rid of the Cryogonal. That's very nice for things like my Greninja. He is then going to send out his Hydreigon. I don't want to risk this thing being scarfed and going for Dark Pulse and knocking me out, so I'm going to go into Florgist, as he actually reveals the Z Sunny Day, which is pretty cool to see. It's going to raise his speed by one. However, this Flamethrower in the sun is still not going to be doing all that much to Florgist, and I'm just going to knock him out with the Moonblast. And I could have gone for a Wish there, but I didn't want him to, like, be a random Iron Tail variant and then be able to 2-hit KO me, and then I would have to click Protect and whatnot. I probably should have gone for Wish, but regardless, differential's not going to matter too much in this game, as he's going to knock out my Florgist with the Tapu Koko, as I am allowed to go out into my Scarfed Roserade. If he were Scarfed, I could have lived. If he were not Scarfed, what just happened would have happened. And then he's going to send in his Staraptor. This is also actually not Scarfed, and then after he knocks me out with the Brave Bird, he is going to live on a very tiny amount of health, which then allows me to go out into either my Greninja or my Jirachi to knock it out. I'm going to go out into my Greninja, and then I'm going to knock it out with the Water Shuriken, winning this game 3-0 and clinching our spot in the playoffs. So, this was a good game. Thank you very much, Tup, for the game. Like I said, check out his YouTube link in the description below. This win guaranteed us playoffs, which is really cool, which means that there's no pressure going into our game versus George, which is very... very relaxing, because having to beat George is not always an easy task. Even though we did it once this season, he is an extremely good battler, and you never know how those games are going to go. So, thank you guys very much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed. Next week, like I said, we are going up against Sceptile MC, aka George, for our last match of the regular season before going into playoffs. We might have a little bit of fun with that game, since I'm already locked for playoffs, and I believe he is at this point as well. But regardless, thank you guys very much for watching. Hope you all enjoyed, and I will see you in the next game.